The next is TS diagrams. Ye pretty old question hai. Okay, they can ask you or na bhi puchega, I'll tell you how to use this concept. What is TS diagrams? Essentially it is temperatures. I give an indication to you. Okay, it is temperature salinity diagrams. What is it? It is a graphical representation of the relationship between temperature and salinity of the oceans. TS diagrams help us identify water masses and their characteristics. What I'm saying here is, because air mass identify karne ke liye, okay, I use temperature and moisture ka horizontal gradients. Okay, in whichever air mass there is not much of temperature variations, in whichever air mass there is not much of moisture variations along a horizontal plane, I say here aapka air mass hai. Okay, so no variations, same air mass, just where variations happen, we say a front. Okay, then again no variation, again a variation, ye got a front hai. Theek hai? So in case of air mass, we define on the basis of this thing. In the waters, we identify on the basis of, okay, some consistency, and the consistency is that of density. But we know the density itself is dependent on temperature and salinity. Okay? So if you want to understand this, this is the challenge. That I need to identify TS diagrams. I need to identify a water mass. To identify water mass, I need to have some physical property which I can measure. Kya kya physical property possible hai? Temperature hai, salinity hai, density hai. We also have properties like amount of oxygen dissolved, amount of carbon dioxide dissolved. Ye bhi property ka part banega. The problem with oxygen and carbon dioxide is that because of water atmospheric interactions, these become highly variable. Okay, is pe aap bharosa nahi kar sakte. Oxygen and carbon dioxide aur jo gases hote hain, these are the variable components and they can change from time to time. So I cannot depend on oxygen and carbon dioxide because of the interaction of water mass with the atmosphere. Mera basta kya hai? Temperature and salinity and density. Of these three, we say density itself depends on temperature and salinity. Okay? So these two, because they don't change for a considerable length of time, temperature and salinity, they don't change because of atmosphere and ocean interactions in short term. Ye bahut aaram se change hote hain. Na carbon dioxide sequestration can happen. The marine life forms can dissolve and consume more carbon dioxide. So these change very fast. But temperature and salinity don't change as rapidly with the interactions of the atmosphere. So we call temperature and salinity as conservative properties. They're more consistent. Ye aaram se change nahi hote. Of course, assuming there is no mixing of water, that's very important. Assuming they don't mix, the waters don't mix, T and S don't change very easily. Hence, T and S are called as conservative properties of water. Because of this, we say that the water mass characteristic can be defined on the basis of temperature and salinity. Okay? Agar ye mujhe ye pata hai, to density bhi mujhe pata hai, more or less. That's the idea. So we have a graphical plot. Okay, on the generally principle aise hota hai ki on the y-axis we plot temperature, on the x-axis we plot salinity. We call this as the TS diagram. Now there are two ways of doing this. यहाँ तक समझ में आ गया और CS diagram? And why I use temperature salinity as the parameter? समझ में आ रही है वाला? Now the two techniques how the TS plotting is done. One is you can plot on the basis of depth of the water. जैसे कि temperature salinity for depth 100 meters. Temperature salinity for the depth say 200 meters. So along this line, ये है depth वाला line. 100 meters depth, 200 meters depth, 1000 meters depth. Okay, temperature is falling, salinity is increasing. Okay, this is 4000 meters depth. So I can plot TS for the depth of the oceans. और ये जो line है ना, for a water mass, it is consistent. If we can do this for different water masses, every water mass has a consistent pattern of this kind. So looking at the graph, I can say, acha, this is the bottom water mass of Arctic Ocean. This is the deep water mass of probably Atlantic Ocean. Okay, so the TS diagram, the depth wala hai, this is consistent for water masses. So do not say that they are homogeneous waters. Don't say that. Okay. The TS diagram is consistent for a water mass. And that's how I recognize a water mass or another water mass. Iska meaning pata hai kya hai? That if for whatever reason, see I know that this is the graph for, it's arbitrary, it's graph for the Antarctic deep water mass. Ye mujhe maine nikal liya. Now if for whatever reason I go and check aur ye aapko graph nahi mila ga, matlab kya hai? The water is changing. It could be global warming change. It could be some pollution related change. Okay. So if the water mass TS diagram does not match with one already plotted earlier, this is indicative of change in the marine environments. Okay. It's like a signature thing. Agar tree hai aur leaves hai, toh green hoga. It's signature wala hoga. Agar green nahi hai, brown ho raha hai, crumble ho raha hai. So I know tree has some problem there. Okay. So TS diagrams help us monitor the health of the marine environments. That's the significance of TS diagram. That's one. Second is, the TS diagrams can be plotted for different sigma values. Ye ek type ka plot hai. TS diagram for different depths. Okay. The second is I'm saying, the TS diagrams can also be plotted for different sigma values. What I mean by this is, okay, again TS hai. If I take sigma values, then you have got very consistent sigma value ke arcs banenge aise. They also are consistent. Say, this is sigma value of 27. This is sigma value 27.8. Sigma value 28. Generally, the sigma value increases like this. Salinity increasing like this, temperature like this. As you come down the graph towards right hand bottom, it becomes more and more dense waters. So, ye bhi ek type ka signature hota hai. Therefore, what this basically means is, along this graph, sigma value ka matlab kya? This is density, right? This is 1.027, okay? Which means, for the entire graph, the density is same. Means temperature T1, salinity S1, same density. Temperature T2, salinity S2, same density. So along this graph, if I change T and S, I still get the same type of density. And this can be one type of air mass, water mass. This can be one type of water mass. But densities are same, but T and S values are different. You get the idea, all of you here? This again is a type of the signature thing. Okay. Agar ye change ho raha hai kisi water ka, okay, then again, there's problem in the marine water environment. So I've discussed this point under four heads. Summing it up. Number one, the TS diagram is a graphical representation. of temperature and salinity. Second is I discussed that why do I consider temperature and salinity as the parameter for identifying the characteristics. Why? Because I said temperature and salinity are conservative properties. The dissolved oxygen content, a variable component, it varies very rapidly with the ocean and atmosphere interactions. Okay, and density itself is a dependent one on temperature and salinity. And for shorter or considerable length of time, T and S don't change. Not as easily, at least. That's why we go for temperature and salinity as the representative, say parameters. Third thing I said, I can draw TS diagram in terms of the depth. And these graphs are consistent graphs for every water mass. Ye signature graphs hote hain for every water mass. Agar aap Google search karoge na, alag alag oceans ka aapko TS diagram mil jayega. And any change in graph in real time condition matlab kya hai? There's some change in the marine environment. And second, I said, I can do it in terms of sigma values also. Okay. For the same sigma value, density, I can have a combination of T and S operating together. Ye bhi ek type ka signature hi hota hai for the water masses. So if I have got water mass, iska sigma value ye hai. Okay. It'll remain this for different values of temperature and salinity. My conclusion is, the TS diagram are one way of depicting and identifying water masses and predicting or studying if there are alterations in the marine environment. That's it all. That's why we use these maps or these diagrams to identify, because see, marine environment mein na change identify karna bahut mushkil hai. Okay. Aur ye long term changes hote hain. They pick up slowly, gradually. Okay. So these water masses tell us they have this. Up to they are also using embedded internet wala devices. They have lowered it, and those devices can tell you exactly how it's changing across time. In real time, they can start mapping.